The hills are alive with the sound of engines. It's race day at the Austrian Grand Prix. The Spielberg circuit then is situated 700 meters above sea level, with just 10 corners making up one of the shortest laps of the season. One time around here is a distance of 2.6 miles, with the best overtaking chances into turn one or the tight uphill turn three. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Bottas, Vettel, Lance Stroll and Perez, Ricciardo, Norris, Leclerc and Carlos Sainz, Ocon, Gasly, Daniel Kvyat and Grosjean, Magnussen, Raikkonen, George Russell, and Antonio Giovinazzi. Latifi and Alexander Albon picks up the last spot on the grid. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track and get this Grand Prix underway.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Hey guys, welcome back to Madrid. Today we place F1 2020 and here we go for 2020 Team 1. This is a challenge with Fernando Alonso around Austria, Austria Grand Prix. This will be the last ever game that playing with that's a special challenge with F1 2021. This will be the last game playing with this, and then I will be doing it.
First lap, keep it up.
We'll be right back.
Access is now enabled. Is clear. Green flag. Full course caution. The safety car is out. Keep an eye on the delta. We need to keep it positive to avoid a penalty. Slow down. Maintain positive delta. Strategy is available on the MFD. Copy. Okay, we can take you this lap. Complete, go now. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires. Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car in this lap. Has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. Gap to teammate behind is 2.0 seconds. plus one lap of extra fuel, fuel target plus one. Four laps of fuel remaining. We're leading our teammate by 6.3 seconds. There's only one lap. Okay, at the current pace and fuel settings, we won't have enough fuel for the end of the race. Consider lowering the fuel mix. This is your final lap of the race. Absolutely awesome. Just amazing. Well done.
Fernando, that's one last question challenge. And we have just got the Styrian Prix. Obviously, we're going to do Austrian Prix. So that is it for everything tonight. Thank you so much for watching.
Another win for the team at Renault today. Really impressive stuff.
Yeah, very, very looking forward to it.
Tell me, Anne, how did they manage to achieve this win?
It was a question of right place, right time today. We were looking at an entirely different race before the safety car came out, but they were able to take full advantage after the field had been bunched up.
As we can see, it's time for the podium, and I can see the Renault team underneath our commentary box going crazy as their drivers walk out. It was a great win, and it means a great deal for this team.
Fantastic, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I very appreciate it. Goodbye.